Service School fans, welcome back to Trash Talk. Baik, bareng gue Ricky Padilla dan hari ini kita lagi di Bintaro. Di restorannya
namanya Nyetik nih.
Dia ada home service juga, sponsored, dan ini salah satu ownernya yang kita akan interview hari ini, RQ Wisnu.
What's up, bro?
How you doing, man?
Thank you.
Eh, man, nice place, man.
Thank you, bro.
And this is one of the owners, cerita lu dong. Yeah, ini bisnisnya apa nih?
So, kita ada barbecue home service. Mm-hmm. Jadi kalau lagi mau bikin kayak acara atau party, you know, you call us, terus kita nanti masakin the steak. You know, this is the type of meal that you get. Yes. You get steak, side dish, french fries, and then kita masakin, siapin semuanya, cuma kalian cuma terima jadi and just enjoy your company, that's it.
Yeah, dan ini pertama kali nih gue interview sambil makan. Yeah. Jadi kan sambil santai aja, Arki, ya. Kita sambil makan steak. Yep. But of course kita di sini Arki kan baru, berita terbesarnya adalah baru extend dengan SM, dan gue biasanya kalau ketemu Arki pas di extend aja sih. Terakhir gue ketemu tuh di Plaza 9 nih. Kita ketemu tuh extend.
There's a certain pattern.
I guess. Yeah. Gue penasaran sih, gue pengen coba dulu.
Yeah, try, man.
I'm gonna try it. So, congratulations though.
Thank
on
you.
On getting a new contract.
Yup.
Season lalu sih, gue kalau lagi nonton IBL gitu, gue selalu ngomong ke subscribers gue, Arki ini jago karena contract year. Because we know that your contract was up. Tapi, just relief gak sih? Udah bisa akhirnya kan, you have to go through free. Kalau gitu, gue nanya ini dulu deh. Gimana sih rasanya jadi free agent? Going through free agency? Kalau di umur segini ya sekarang ya?
Kalau dari sisi pemain ya,
yeah.
Emang penting banget sih. Like I'm always, I know it's my contract year. Mm-hmm. I have to work. I have to show that, you know, I can still keep up with the young guns and stuff like that. You know, apalagi tahun kemarin kan ada Indonesia muda kan?
Oh yeah, ada Indonesia.
The junior national team.
Uh-huh.
So I have to show that I can keep up with them still and stuff like that. Tapi yeah, man, it's just I'm more focused. But every year, you know, targetnya masih sama, mm-hmm. always juara. Jadi I'm still hungry. I'm still passionate for the game and
yeah. Santai aja bro, ambil makan bro. Gua udah makan.
No, go ahead. And I already cut my steak.
Okay, I already cut my steak. Enak juga nih. Tapi kalau kayak gitu lo lagi free agency gitu ya. Mm. Lo biasanya ngobrolnya konsultnya sama siapa sih? About your next move.
Yeah, I have a manager sih. I think it's important sebagai pemain basket kita ada representation. Terus ngomong sama biar lebih enak soal negosiasi kontrak sama manajernya SM or whoever gitu.
Istri?
Istri pasti dikasih tahu about like who's contacting us and stuff like that. Pasti she's part of this, the decision, you know.
Cariin alu lah. Tapi proses lu untuk free agency sebelum lu decide untuk extend sama SM itu berapa lama sih biasanya? Is it like 1 month, 3 weeks?
You know, yeah.
Because I know a couple of teams was trying to get you too, right?
Yeah. When it comes to contract, saya nggak suka buru-buru. Mm. Like I think in order, it's something serious, you know, because it's not just a one year thing.
Yeah.
It's something that you have to focus on for the next like 2, 3, four maybe. Jadi kayak you have to make sure everything is covered perfect. Jadi nggak mau jangan buat pemain basket in the future jangan buru-buru soal signing your contract.
Ini super max deal nih. Your last super max deal?
I don't know. Hopefully not the last.
Kan biasanya kalau pemain NBA itu kalau ada umur kayak 33 gitu biasanya carinya udah terakhir-terakhir tuh biasanya tuh super max deal, karena kan biasanya pemain basket prime-nya 28, 33, 34 lah ya boleh dibilang ya.
Yeah.
After that udah tinggal finishing their career saya. Nah, what was the gua kayak kalau gua tahu ini adalah 3+1 ya. So 3 years and then 1 year player option nantinya. Option lu 37 kali.
37. Yeah, 37 sih.
Kalau lu sendiri ngeliat diri lu mau main sampai umur berapa sih?
Yeah, honestly belum tahu sih. Soalnya it's like tergantung as of now saya belum bosen sama main basket.
Oh, okay.
Jadi it's like aku tetap mau main basket, tapi if my body says yo, that's it. It's enough. Udah tua, nggak bisa main lagi ya. Udah, it's time. Nggak bisa maksa. You know?
Yeah, yeah.
Jadi ya gitu.
Tapi what was the biggest deciding factor though for you to finally say, oh yeah, going back to SM, man?
I mean, you know, no matter how many teams contacted me, so I'll during free agency, SM tetap di prioritize because you know SM, I've been here for 10 years. That's like,
okay.
No matter what, I have a special bond with SM. Gue udah juara berapa kali sama SM kan. You know, through those 10 years, saya udah, they treated me so well. Yeah. You know, I've gotten so many opportunities with them. Being able to, through basketball and through them, I've met my wife. Yeah. I've got a house. I've got businesses and assets and stuff like that. Jadi, it's like, for the hubungannya saya sama SM is like begini banget.
Okay.
So, like SM is always the first priority, you know. I love SM. They treat me well and can't go wrong.
Can't go wrong with SM. Kita ngomongin tentang bisnis mungkin nanti ya. Setelah kita selesai ngobrolin basket. Dave, I was about to ask you one question and now I forgot what I was about to ask you. Okay. Kita ngomongin pelatih dulu deh. Pelatih nih orang udah pada tahu semua lah ya. Coach Milos going to Timnas Muda, yeah. And Coach Yobel coming back to SM. Mm-hmm. Kalau jadi pemain sendiri tuh sistemnya tuh mirip apa gimana sih? Jadi pusing nggak sih ganti-ganti tiap tahun ganti pelatih gitu?
At first I think ganti-ganti pelatih agak pusing sih because like through 10 years I've been here udah 4 pelatih juga kan.
Okay.
Nah terus ganti-ganti sistem tapi kalau yang ini sih I think emang berubah. I got different because see Milos actually brings his European version to Indonesia, and then the style of like disciplinary and stuff emang beda dibandingin yo Coach Yobel gitu. Tapi it's still like yeah going back to Coach Yobel kan aku sama SM udah pernah juara sama Coach Yobel, so kita udah like I'm already familiarized, udah tahu he understands my game, I understand his system. Jadi yeah it's fine sih kalau
gue udah habis duluan lo stage-nya, padahal gue tadi bilang gue nggak lapar tapi akhirnya gue makan lebih banyak. Ini manajernya Arki mau masuk kamera juga
kayaknya.
Cameo. Oke, ini apa lagi nih?
Lupa buat tangan yang ini.
Ini beda lagi nih, apa ya, lagi?
Kalau nggak mau steak, ini ada Wagyu steak.
Oke, ini nggak punya kameraman, nggak bisa di zoom jadinya.
Pakai sambal hijau.
Oh damn, I cannot eat that. That's too spicy for me.
Masa?
Yeah, I can't eat spicy food.
Buat yang suka pedas. Yeah.
But this is good though, the steak. Coming back, okay, karena gue inget pertanyaan gue. Okay, you won 4 rings, right?
Yes.
You have 4 rings with SM. You got everything already, MVP. Six-man, I think you got 6-man too, right?
6-man, 2 kali malah.
2 kali, right? So you got everything, you won everything. Gimana sih caranya, you know? Ataupun apa sih yang masih Arki cari in basketball?
You know, honestly, like, gue nggak even soal MVP, soal like those individual achievements, gue nggak nyari juga sih. Mm-hmm. It's just the only thing gue nyari sih juara sih. Jadi kayak along the way, ya kebetulan aja I've been awarded those achievements. Tapi it's just like, you know, I do what's necessary for the team. Like, you know, one year I have to be MVP, the next year if I have to be sixth man, ya udah. Tapi sebenarnya soal individual itu gue nggak nyariin trofinya soal itu. It's just whatever kebutuhan buat tim, yeah, I'm ready to give it for them.
Dan lu udah juara ABL juga, I cannot forget about
ABL
that.
ABL juga.
Indonesia yeah, Awards. How many medals do you have? SEA Games.
SEA Games 2, 2015, 2017 for SEA Games. Yeah.
Ini mau coba jadi GOAT nih di Indonesia.
Pasti bisa. You know. It's not gonna be easy.
Yeah.
Tapi.
Who has the most championship ya? Individually ya? Gue penasaran sih, gue gak pernah tahu sih.
In my opinion, as a player, kalau gak salah sih, Dodo.
Dodo ya?
Wow. If I'm not mistaken, he has 10?
Wow!
8 or 10, kalau gak salah ya.
Wow, that's gonna be tough to catch up.
I know, gue baru, I think it's 8. Gue baru setengah sih.
Yeah, so you gotta play until you're 42, bro.
I don't know, I'm coming for you. You didn't make it easy, but I'm coming.
Gila, Dodo kok 8? I think probably 8 though, because Dodo main di Satria Muda udah dari zaman lama banget kan?
Iya, yeah. He had that one run yang kayak 6 kali in a row kan? So,
Yeah, that GOAT conversation jangan di NBA aja. Di IBL harus ada juga GOAT conversation, you know? Biar seru. Tapi, damn. Now, let's go to Timnas. Timnas nih akhirnya lagi persiapan ya. Going to Las Vegas and then after that you guys gonna play in Lebanon. Jadi pemain gitu abis IBL lanjut.
Yeah.
When you have time man for the family man?
Yo, it's tough man. Ever since gue masuk timnas 2015, it's always been off season timnas, balik ke musim, and then tapi it's just like, yeah, gue harus cari aja waktu learn time management, you know.
Okay.
It's tough. You have to make time basketball and for family. Kayak kemarin aja, latihan pagi, siangnya to drive back to Bintar to tiup lilin for her birthday, and then sorenya latihan lagi. So like I barely even saw her for her birthday. Tapi it's like, yeah, you know what's important to you? Pasti di prioritize buat kasih waktu.
Those sacrifices gila juga ya. Yeah. People probably won't see that. Kayak orang nggak mungkin nggak pernah lihat kali ya. Kayak behind the scenes sih. Kayak pemain itu capek, man. Yeah. Like they're tired. Like, mereka latihan pagi, and then they have still have to make time for their families. And sorenya latihan lagi. Besok tidur, besoknya latihan lagi. Yeah. How do you manage your body, man?
Recovery is key. Like, you know, dikit-dikit I try to make sure ada ice bath, compress, massage, or prevention injury workout and stuff like that is important. So it's not just like 2 jam kita latihan cukup, tapi ada there's more than that. So
gila, jadi atlet berat ya. You've been doing it since 2011 though.
Yeah,
professionally. Gila ya. Gak berasa ya 10 tahun?
Gak berasa
10 tahunnya udah di Indonesia sekarang ini. Arki, gila.
It's fun though.
Yeah, it's fun.
It's fun.
I hope you play like 6 more years. Indonesia still need you.
I hope so.
And Indonesia sekarang kan kita gak tahu ya, maksudnya we don't know yet if Marquise, kita harapkan si Marquise akan join kalian nanti di Las Vegas. But from what you see kan, lu udah pernah latihan ya? Sempat latihan bareng kan? Sama Marquise di Jakarta ya?
Tapi gak lama sih, soalnya
how many days?
Paling berapa minggu.
Oh, okay.
Like maybe 1 or 2 weeks.
Gua mau tahu itu aja deh, your first impression ya pas ketemu Marquise.
The first time kita latihan bareng sih, I was amazed with loncatnya dia, tinggi banget sih. And then dia masih muda, jadi like potentially, like dia belum matang menurut saya. Like umur 22 kalau gak salah dia, like dia masih bisa tambah jago sih harusnya. And then the experience he has yang dia main di Division 1, G League, Summer League, segala macam, he could be good for it. Let me just see menurut gue.
We are all excited sih, karena apalagi kan kita tahu we are heading into FIBA World Cup ya, 2023.
Yeah, FIBA World Cup.
We are so excited and we are of course semua wishing Timnas all the best. Semoga Timnas juga bisa lolos ke FIBA World Cup 2023 nantinya.
Yeah, just win or lose, remember, just keep supporting us.
No, I know. Kita sih win or lose pasti support lah, gak mungkin lah, enggak lah. Tapi kadang-kadang sama ada netizen.
Yeah.
Netizen agak gila, ada ngomongin netizen. Okay, let's talk about netizen. Pemain-pemain itu, ini kan kita seru-seruan ya podcast ya. Pemain itu seberapa sering sih baca komen?
Yo, honestly, I mean, kita udah di digital age.
Yeah.
Like, you know, of course we see what you write. It's just, you know, some players bisa handle it better than other people.
Okay.
Tapi ya menurut gua it's just you're entitled to your opinion. Tapi lo jangan terlalu so tahu aja sih. Like you act like you see the problem and you can make the solution right there. Like it's not, it's a process. You
know, it is a process. Everything is a process. But what about you though? Do you read all those comments?
Nah, not everything. It's just, so it comes to the point sometimes this is the same comments you guys. Like now the comments is Arki's too old. Arki udah nggak pantas ya. That's up to you.
Like, well, gue sih cuma bilang selalu Arki sering fall trouble aja sih. Yeah.
Tapi you have to understand the situation juga. Like, you know, there's some like sometimes. All right, for example, I'm a soal foul trouble. The SM. We don't have like a bad boy buat disuruh, hey yo, we need you to foul him biar dia takut penetrasi gitu ya.
Kevin Jonas nggak bisa ya?
Bukan dia nggak bisa. I'm not saying. Sometimes it's not like an instinct for some people. Like for me, if I see somebody going up for a dunk, I'm gonna foul you right away.
Okay.
Because that's how I was raised. Yeah. Like no easy baskets. Biar pas the next time you penetrate, you see me.
Yeah.
Udah.
Yeah,
oh, ada Aki. I'm not gonna go up. Now that's the mindset I'm trying to give. Like, kalian harus tahu ya. Sometimes I have to do that because we don't have that bad boy or player that's just like, okay yo, go beat him up, like stuff like that gitu aja.
Gue sama Arki coba ya ngomong, gue kasih tahu aja gue ngomong apa tentang dia. Tapi kan at least gue bilang selalu kayak Arki.
I take it. You can talk negative about me. I take it for constructive criticism. I'll eat the butt.
Because I want you to stay on the court.
Yeah, I know. I understand.
That's what I'm saying, cause I always say that Arki tuh masih pemain Indonesia yang punya IQ basketball yang paling tinggi menurut gue. You know, I think how you see the game is still different. Kayak lo kayak di lapangan tuh masih tenang banget, and you know how like to make the right passes gitu loh. But
then you have to also understand, you know, sometimes referees they just don't like me.
Yeah, itu.
Arki foul.
Yeah, itu. Itu out of my control.
Yeah, exactly. It's out of my control juga. Jadi kayak, yeah, okay, my bad guy.
Yeah.
But me,
I enjoy watching you play on the court. You know, sometimes when you get like 3 fouls in like 2 quarters, I'll be like, Arki, come on, man, not again, gitu loh. Lebih kayak gitu.
I know.
You know, but I'm trying to be honest though with all the players. Gue kayak orangnya nggak yang ngumpet-ngumpet ngomong kayak bilang ini kayak gini gitu. Like if I have something to say, I'll say it to the players. Like you know. But, kita sampai mana tadi? Sampai timnas ya. Oke, gue mau balik lagi ke SM sebelum gue lupa. You guys lost Choke, Rivaldo, couple of young players, but people keep forgetting that the core players are still there. The core players are still there. Hardianus probably going into his prime.
Yes.
Boleh kita bilang juga kayaknya Laurentius Oy not even going into his prime.
Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, masih not yet. And Kevin Jonas not yet. Maybe Joan Loren going into his prime, and Arki still in his prime.
We still have Afan too.
Afan too. People keep forgetting. People bilang, wah, hilang Rivaldo, hilang Choke. Gimana nih SM? But ini core playersnya masih ada di sini, dan lo ngelihat untuk next season, are you guys apa? Ya, gimana ya? Are you guys? Gue mau bilang nggak worry sih, but how do I say it? How do you guys approach next season with losing Choke and losing Rivaldo? Of course, they are rotation players too.
Mm-hmm. Maksud gue sih, gue belum dapet team di SM yang kayak every year, the next year sama.
Yeah.
I don't think I've had it. Pasti ada a year yang kayak berubah kan. Nah emang, for next season, yeah, Choke played decent minutes. Uh-huh. Rivaldo played decent minutes, and they played well too.
Yeah. Tapi, Rookie of the year.
Yeah, exactly. Tapi you have to understand, yeah, we still, like you said, we still have our core players. And then, yeah, sebagai senior juga, what we lost is my job to help teach those other players to fill that role, gitu. Mm. Jadi kayak, yeah, it would have been nice if we still had Choke and Faldo. Tapi ya udah, ini saatnya buat who's gonna play those minutes, Wisnu or si Apa or anybody. Yeah, so like, you know. I'm confident in their game that they'll step up with the minutes that they're given. So you know, this offseason they've been working hard. So
yeah, and gua nggak tahu rukinya SM kapan akan mainnya, but when I saw the video dari channelnya SM, they're bigs, bro.
Yeah.
Mereka gede-gede ya.
Yeah, and I'm beating them up every day so that they're ready when it's playoff time. Mereka harus siap. So like, the way I see approach it is, they get the same, maybe even worse treatment than the veterans because, like, just because you're a rookie, if I see potential in you as a rookie, like, yeah, gue mau lo main, gue nggak cuma mau lo, I don't want, who wants, siapa mau pakai polo, you know? So like, I try to make sure that they're prepared.
But gaming, gimana gaming mereka? Apakah you like their game, the rookies? I haven't seen them play yet.
I like the potential. Uh-huh. Well, as of now, cuma.
Is Calvin playing? Is Calvin playing? Yeah, Calvin playing, right?
He should be playing for this season, yeah, right? For this harusnya season. Tapi I don't know kan there might be Indonesia Patriots again, so nggak ngerti soalnya. Tapi ya, I mean he in practice I like him a lot, you know, he's big size, dia berani kayak one on one nya lawan the veteran in his position and stuff like that. But yeah, I'm looking forward to him to making an impact next season if he stays. Emang kalau disuruh main sama sih.
And now Arki kan udah tahun ke 10 ya di Indonesia. Kalau Arki sendiri lihat perkembangan basket di Indonesia selama 10 tahun terakhir itu gimana sih?
I think skill wise, competitiveness improved banget sih since my first year as a rookie. Like I think it's more spread out. Like everybody's playing. Like you can tell there are some players that have improved individually, especially with now there's pelatih dari luar negeri, so the locals are learning more from these outside coaches. You know, players are during the off season are taking more serious with their workouts and stuff like that. But individually, like I think it's improving. It's just hopefully we can grow.
Do you want to see more players going to like international league like Tuado going to Japan. Would you like to see that more in the future?
Yeah, you know, I'm rooting for players like Brandon to play overseas. You know, I mean, we have talent in the in Indonesia. It's just I think our biggest issue is size. But other than that, I think we have players that have the skill that can play overseas. It's just opportunity dapat atau enggak because of the way our schedule is. Kan kayak how can we play in the local league and then play in, let's say, liga di luar kalau kita ada timnas juga, stuff like that. Ribet, susah juga.
Lo dari Jepang ada yang nawarin?
Nah, I mean, if I'm not mistaken, itu juga kan, don't you have to put your name in a jersey?
I think so.
Yes, I didn't understand.
Masa nggak ada yang kayak nanya-nanya gitu? Is Arki available?
Gua fokus di sini aja. Nanti lu terlalu kangen sama gue.
Ah, benar juga. Terlalu lama ya. Tapi ngomongin, sekarang kita ngomongin bisnis deh. How many businesses you have now?
You know, I had a few. Tapi with the whole pandemic, I'm pretty sure everybody was affected by it. But I had like, you know, through basketball, I was able to meet and network with so many people. Trying to get out of my comfort zone and trying different industries. You know, this is one. I've had a restaurant, but it shut down. Another restaurant, it shut down because of PPKM and stuff like that. Perfume industry, distribution.
Okay.
And then, yeah, stuff like that. I'm trying to jump into crypto. It's learning. Yo, you gotta keep up, bro. You can't just be stuck behind.
I'm scared of crypto.
Yo, it is scary, but yo, man.
But if you're lucky, you get the jackpot.
Yeah,
you'll be rich.
You don't try to be like a millionaire long soon.
Yeah,
I mean, you know, a little profit is some profit. You gotta think it like that. The same thing, like you don't have to buka restaurant long soon. Yeah. Kayak gini, buka booth kecil kayak gerobak.
Yeah,
you're still making income. Like don't think you have to be rich automatically gitu.
Yeah, I know.
Just have the mindset of creating multiple passive incomes gitu aja
sebagai. Yeah. I want to open a restaurant too.
Yeah,
I'm thinking about it with my wife.
You probably open up like a club or something.
No, nasi goreng kobotak. Club is just now it's club is susah. Club juga tuh susah. Oh, yeah, pandemic juga nggak bisa, lo harus pakai masker clubbing.
You're right.
I mean like,
yeah.
It passed our times already, bro. Dulu still house sih, okay.
This is the new Rocky.
Yeah, this is the new Rocky. Dulu sih.
Oh, Rocky. Oh,
beda cerita dulu. Every weekend at the still house dulu. It's okay. You can see me. You can find me next to the DJ booth.
Gua sih nggak tahu still house. I've never been there. Gua anak baik.
Gua minum kopi aja nih. But crypto, did you get Shiba Inu?
I had it.
You had it.
I had it, but I sold it earlier.
Damn! I heard itu gede banget untungnya ini.
You know it's so cheap. So like, if you really bought a lot early, then it was. And you know, actually, who told me about it early was Lester. Lester told me. But I held on to it. But I already made a profit off it. But if I held on to it, I would have made more. But it wasn't like my main bag. So like, even if I kept it, it would be like, yeah, okay lah. But not
your main bag is Bitcoin or what?
Nah, there's a few. I'm like into a couple of other altcoins, like Cardano or.
Oh yeah, everybody got that too.
Solana.
Yeah, cause I saw it on TikTok. Gue kalau lihat crypto gitu, lihatnya dari TikTok gitu. Yeah. Jadi kemana ada yang
TikTok or Twitter? Like I used Twitter like the last time I used Twitter was like 2013, and then I just stopped. And then all of a sudden I started playing crypto saham and everything. It's like, oh, I have to use Twitter to keep up with all the news. So I'm on Twitter again now.
I'm on Twitter too now because I can keep up with all the NBA news from Twitter. It's better. But crypto, gue kemarin lihat si Shiba Inu itu. Kalau lo belinya dari tahun lalu gitu, terus lo masih simpen sampai sekarang, you're a millionaire now, they say.
But it depends on how much you had bought that.
They say about like $2,000, if you got like $2,000.
Yeah, that's a lot because it's like 0.000008 cents.
That's not a lot, bro. You got like 300 million.
Yeah, but I'm saying, yeah, I mean.
Dollars for iffy, extension, man, yeah. For 3 years. Supermax deal, so you good.
Tapi kan I just jumped into crypto, gue masih belajar, gue gak mungkin langsung.
Yeah.
Main gede, just the thing is jangan takut masuk dikit aja.
Gue takut, gue gak mau berani gue.
Everything's a risk, bro.
Everything is a risk, though. That's true, that's true. Even business, too.
Yeah, everything's business is a risk. You know, signing a contract to team A, B, or C is a risk, too. So,
that's
just,
true.
Just jangan takut aja.
Bro, have you been thinking about life after basketball?
I mean, I have. Tapi belum kayak, like I can't say, okay, once basketball is done, gue langsung masuk.
Saya masih fokus lah ya.
Yeah, cause I have to focus on basketball first. Maybe once like the last 2 years of my contract baru like bener-bener. Tapi that's the whole point of sambil main basket, jalanin bisnis biar at least kalau tiba-tiba harus berhenti, I still have income coming in.
But I wanna know though, last question. How do you see yourself though in 10 years? Where do you see yourself?
In 10 years?
Yeah, in 10 years.
In 10 years, I'll be chilling in the beach. I don't know if it's gonna be in Bali or if it's gonna be a beach in the US or I don't know. Yeah, but all I know is I'm gonna be with my family. Hopefully they're happy with everything that I provided with them through basketball and everything that I've done here so far. So
but do you have plan though, going back to the US?
I'm not sure. See, I can't say that either because you know, I've said gue mau main basket di Indonesia cuma 2 tahun and then now sudah tahun ke-11. Jadi kayak jangan bilang anything can happen from now to the next 3-4 years, you know.
Kau jadi coach?
As of now gue enggak ada pikiran sih, tapi ya bisa aja.
Wah, gila tambahan lagi makanannya.
Nih opsi lagi nih,
opsi
nasi,
lagi,
goreng.
Nasi goreng.
Nasi goreng.
Kita ada berapa makan yang kita dari udah kenyang banget sih. But crazy. Jadi lo belum kepikiran lah ya, cause I mean like, I just wanna know how you see yourself aja sih ke depannya sih, cause basketball is only temporary, right?
Bukan temporary, basketball is like
I'm playing basketball is temporary.
Oh yeah. I can't play forever. Tapi it's gonna be part of my journey. Mungkin gua nggak langsung ke lapangan, tapi basketball somehow is probably in 10 years still gonna be part of me. Udah pasti. Maybe commentator, maybe once via pensión, gua take over trash talk.
That would be cool though. Tapi gua pengen masih sih for my IBL itu like you know, comfortable in front of camera, bisa ngomong. Kadang-kadang pemain-pemain IBL malu-malu gitu.
Yeah, tapi again, one of the key things buat bisa maju as a player is getting out of your comfort zone. Gua sebenarnya, I think my rookie season, gua masih malu-malu juga. I mean, like my bahasa wasn't that. It's still not great now. Tapi maksudnya, I'm more confident. Yeah. Tapi ya, lo harus bisa aja. Like,
tapi seru dong, bikin vlog sama SM. I enjoy it. Gue selama pandemi, gue nonton semua vlognya SM. And the bubble ya. Yeah. The bubble, it was like menurut gue itu lucu banget dan seru banget sih.
We had to do. It was being in a bubble is tough, man. We had to try to make it fun. But I mean, it worked.
How was that experience though?
It was new. Soalnya apalagi kan gue udah berapa tahun udah kayak abis latihan udah pulang aja kan. But now I'm back kayak gue lagi jadi rookie lagi, gue nginep lagi di mess every day for 30 days. I see the same people. And then it's just like, what are we doing today? We can't really do much juga in the bubble kan.
PS5 right?
Yeah, tapi it's like, you can't play PS5 with 15 people at the same time. Jadi it's like my PS5, it's maybe doing extra workout or main capsa gitu, like udah like we had to figure out. Tapi untungnya kayak kita udah like udah family, so it's normal, like okay. I think that's important too, kalau bubble, like being around the people, like people that you can be around.
Who's the best 2K player on SM?
It would have to be between Afan and yang sering main mulu sih Juan. So harusnya Juan sih jago, harusnya ya.
Ini Juan Loren ya?
Yeah, Juan Loren. So okay. Gue nggak tahu sih. Soalnya gue jarang. Gue jujur ya. Gue.
Lu mainnya apa?
I watch Netflix. Oh. I play Sims. I'm old. I play Sims.
Look at my wife, bro. You just like my wife play Sims.
And itu aja, like I play one day and then abis itu it's like, yo, siapa yang mau main aja. I don't even play.
Itu yang punya PS5 nya siapa? Gua kira lu yang punya.
Enggak, jadi emang bos beli buat tim.
Okay.
Nah, tapi kan ada dua. Ya, satu langsung hak captain dong.
Hak apa?
Captain.
Oh, captain. Oke.
Okay. Mau pasti di kamar. Jadi satunya ya di rotasi.
Arki, thank you so much man for a fun conversation and thank you so much for the great food.
Thank you guys. Kalau mau remember go, we're on Instagram too, nyetik.barbecue. Go to GoFood atau Grab udah ada juga, or langsung ke Bintaro. Kita ada indoor and outdoor.
Yes, kopinya juga enak di sini. I had my latte. Wanna order another one after this. And it's really hot because today is really hot. Yeah. Good luck man in Las Vegas
and Lebanon.
Semoga bisa menang di sana and you know, give your best and balik lagi ke sini ntar SM. Stay healthy. Jangan cedera. Semoga bisa menang another championship next season
with
with SM. Semoga bisa three-peat lah.
At least minimal three-peat.
So, thank you so much once again. Guys, yes, thank you man. And jangan lupa untuk follow Arki juga di Instagram. Kalau mau lihat koleksi-koleksi sepatunya Arki. Dan juga kemarin dia baru aja digerebek rumahnya sama Avan. I just watched that. Yeah, I just watched that last night. So, make sure you guys juga support Avan tuh. YouTube channel ya, bantuin subscribe juga ke sana. So, guys, yeah, thank you so much for watching. And we'll see you guys again on the next video. Peace out.